We're here with Jessie Martinez, 1-0, one knockout, right?
Yeah.
How was the transition from being an amateur to being a pro?
It wasn't too difficult. It wasn't too different. Like I always felt like I had a better style for the pros than for the amateurs.
Why?
I never really felt like I could get off so many punches. I always felt like I could really
just land some bombs.
Land some good punches. Yeah, yeah. So I felt like it was easy to adapt once I had my pro debut. And it just felt like that was my style, like trying to land a good punch.
Like, which fighter in history would you compare your style?
Ask yourself.
I'm not sure. I've watched a lot of fighters, and just watching them, I like to do the moves they do. Like a move, for example, Canelo. I like a lot of, like, where he feints here, comes with a punch, or feint here, comes with a punch.
Yeah, he moves like that.
Yeah,
who else?
I also like those flashy fighters that are almost untouchable, like Rigondeaux. Like, he uses his jab, he moves, but he's southpaw.
Okay. If Rigondeaux fights Lomachenko, who wins?
I think Rigondeaux wins.
Why?
I think he's just too good of a boxer. He uses his good punches, he has good speed. He's small. I heard he's really small for his weight class. Like, but he uses that good speed and good footwork. And
Lomachenko,
really
two-time
good.
Gold medalist. Rigo, yeah. Two-time gold medalist.
Yeah, yeah.
A lot of gold.
Lomachenko's good also, though. Yeah. I like Lomachenko, but.
But you say Rigo now.
I kind of feel like Rigondeaux would win that
okay.
Fight.
How about Cotto Canelo?
I like Canelo, but I'm a fan of Cotto also. But I don't know. I think Canelo takes this fight.
Mayweather Berto, what do you think?
I think Mayweather.
Why?
I don't know. I don't think Berto really has what it takes to beat Mayweather, but you never know. Like, you could pull off some lucky punch or something could be unexpected in that. But no, I think Mayweather is going to win that.
Even though you only have one pro fight, you already had an opportunity to step in the ring with a lot of famous fighters. Who's the toughest dude you ever sparred? Who you say like hits the hardest? Yeah, man.
I've sparred a lot of people that are not pros that also hit very hard.
Like who? Who is the hardest of anyone you ever sparred?
I'm not sure.
Hard to say?
I mean, John Molina,
yeah, he could crack.
Big punch.
You know what I always tell people? I've been punched by a lot of fighters, but Molina, I could feel that shit for a week.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, like
he's got a really good punch, yeah. Yeah, big punch.
Hey, he's being modest. It's me.
Have you ever sparred Brandon?
Yeah. I used to spar him a lot.
Do you ever land a big one?
He's landed big punches, yeah.
Have you ever landed a big
punch? I don't know. You'd have to ask him.
he's come close a few times.
He has power?
Me and Jesse probably have sparred 1,000 rounds together, but nowadays he just kicks my ass.
All right, there. Tell people where to follow you, Jesse.
You can follow me on Instagram under Magic Martinez with a double Z at the end, or my Facebook, Jesse Eddie Martinez.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Facebook.com and release back reporting.